Hello loves, we're back again with Stranger Things. Back again for you guys, immediately on to the next one for me. I did say in the end of the last episode that I may just sit down and carry on, and I literally did. I quickly scoffed some food and I was like, get me back on that Stranger Things, let's have some more. So here we are for another episode. Last episode was a bit up and down for me. I definitely enjoyed it, but my hatred for Nancy is growing by the minute, so we're gonna see how that goes. I'm still not that impressed by Steve, so he really needs to be like leveling up for me right now. He's not hitting the standard. And I'm actually a surprisingly big fan of Jonathan. I like him so far, although he did just get creepy at the end of last episode. Although really, I just need to get back into it because I need to know what happens to my girl Barb, because I like her. I relate to Barb. I'm a Barb myself. Like, come on now, don't let me down, Stranger Things. Don't forget to like the video, do all of the nice things for me, because these episodes are a lot of work, you guys. Come on, leave me some love and subscribe to see the rest of the series, all of that stuff that I usually do at the end. We're gonna do it at the beginning because come on, leave me some love. And that's enough messing around, let's get into the episode. I am nervous. Oh, that's a dope intro. Really nervous now. Fuck off. A, do not start with the jump scare. B, I do not like how this is looking for Barb right now. What the fuck?
Hello?
Shh. What the fuck? And she's shagging Steve right now, really. I don't like how they've cut these two in together. This makes me very uncomfortable. Leave her alone.
Hey, what's the matter?
Did she think she heard her?
Nothing.
Get the fuck out of there. Go, 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 go. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. No, 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 no. Oh, this is so well edited, but it makes me so uncomfortable. Come on, her hand come back up. Hand come back up. Do we just lose Barb? Did my character in this just die? That goes really well for me. That really bodes well for how I would cope with this situation. Although, okay, let's put it together, right? Mainly in life, I'm Barb. I really am. I'm that friend. And I wouldn't have got drunk at the party either and all of that. But also, I have no willpower. So if the cards had turned and Steve had been interested in me, let's be real, I would probably be Nancy right now because I have zero willpower. So, who knows who I am in this? I'm Eddie's girlfriend. Can't you tell from the look? I'm Eddie's girl. Obviously. I'm just chatting shit right now. Pure shit. Did they do it? I mean, they've left her dressed exactly as she was before. She's not any less dressed, so... But he's asleep, which makes me think he probably got some. What are we supposed to think?
Steve.
Also, did she stay all night? She was supposed to be home by 10. That's called the cold shoulder, my girl, when you let a boy like that sleep with you. No, it's still night time. See, they're making it seem like they want you to believe that they did it, but also she was still dressed exactly the same, so did they just make out and then, like, he passed out from being too drunk? Like, do we ever find out? Or is this just up for, you know, for us to decide? So it was close enough that she could have walked home, so why did she drive?
Steve's.
Oh, Mum's on to you.
It's no big deal.
Mum knows.
You can talk to me. Nothing happened.
Mum's no, dude. She can see it in your eyes. She's a good mom. She's a really good mom. And it's hard when you put the groundwork in to try and have the relationship where you think your kids will tell you and feel comfortable to tell you anything, and then you know something's happened and they haven't told you. Like, that's gotta be hard, because you feel like you would kind of feel like, I thought I would have done enough to earn the trust, you know what I mean? Not that it should be about you, but you'd be like, really thought you could trust me and we had the kind of relationship where you'd tell me so I can, like, make sure you're okay. Like, yeah, that's hard. Christ, okay.
Talk to me. Just say something.
Mum's cracked.
He's trying to talk to you.
He's through the through the lights.
Mom.
I know.
This isn't helping.
I have nothing to say because I'm like, I see both sides at the moment and I feel really bad for her. I can see why you'd think she'd lost it. And it would be fair to totally lose it when your kid is missing, like. But also, like, she really did see something and she needs him to believe her.
You seriously think that the weirdo knows where Will is?
Stop calling her the weirdo as well.
But if there is something out there, I'm gonna shoot it in the eye and blind it.
Gotta love kids. He's gonna be like Snags. Yeah. This is me.
She shut one door!
With her mind! Are you kidding me? That's insane!
He has a point.
Okay, one more time.
She's like, I could, but I'm not going to.
Michael!
Coming!
Oh my god. If I had screamed like that up to my mom, she'd have come down those stairs to beat me. Where's the discipline? Like, I know I said their mom is awesome, but do not tell me those girls were just judging her. If he has been telling people, me and Steve are done. Although I have to say, I'm not sure what you expected.
Hey. Oh, I didn't tell anyone.
But his arsehole friends
like
probably did.
And Carol?
Are you a fuckboy or are you decent? I genuinely can't tell, so I'm not surprised that she's confused. But why are you not wondering where Barb is?
Hey, Allie. Where's Barb?
Oh, now you think about her. But like, apart from anything, you realise she doesn't want to hear about last night because you were an arsehole. I mean, kind of not, because yeah, it's... She was an asshole to ask her to go knowing that she wanted to do what she wanted to do, you know what I mean? And to then be like, oh, I'm fine, and expect her friend to be like, cool, awesome. You should have been upfront at first.
Now, I know the kid's not in there, but I gotta check off this box. Would you speak to your boss and see what you could swing for us? I'm talking 10 minutes, tops.
Smooth, smooth. And there's Lonnie being like, oh, is Hopper still in charge? Like, he's a shit cop. He's the best they've got for a start. Second of all, you're a fucking idiot. I knew she could float that thing. Don't go upstairs. Child, if you get caught, that is your own fault. I was about to be like, that's some thick ass carpet. But I'm like, oh, it's the 80s. And also, we have carpet that thick in our house right now. So, I can't judge. But of course, she's interested by everything. Because if she's been raised in a lab, like, everything here is new. So, I kind of don't blame her. I wonder if she's ever seen a TV. If she hasn't, she's gonna switch that on and freak out. Or not. He-Man! On the beach and in the sun, the real thing is so much fun. This is such a throwback. Oh, because she's had Cancer Coke before, okay. Although she's been asked to move Cancer Coke. Or asked to crush it, Jesus. She always gets nosebleeds, which can't imply anything good's going on in her brain when that happens. Okay, Mum, what are you doing? Fucking Jonathan's gonna come home and be like, Mum, I told you to stop being weird. What the fuck is happening now? Even the dog's like, bro, are you okay? Don't tell me now she needs more Christmas lights. Oh, it is actually near Christmas time. Okay, I was gonna say, because otherwise he's gonna be like, how does this help with your missing son?
Joyce.
Just ring me up, Donald.
She's so done with this shit, though.
Those cameras, you keep the tapes?
Gonna be like, yeah, but I don't want to give them to you because then you're gonna see 11 escaping.
And he builds a space laser.
Space lasers?
Ignore him.
Yeah, most of us do. Thing is, it doesn't even look sus because cameras back then were so bad anyway.
Yeah, a lot of rain that night. See any rain on that tape?
See, Hopper's smart.
But they're lying.
See, Lonnie can go suck on one, like, implying that fucking Hopper isn't a good cop. Hopper's an excellent cop. Thank God, really, because every other cop in this town is trash. Oh, of course, we're back in the area where... Ew, it's growing. With the breathing wall. Surely if it's spores or stuff, though, we've just seen that fan going directly into that room. It's pumping the spores out into the rest of the town. Like, has nobody thought of this? Or do they just not care? This is some Resident Evil style shit right now. But seriously, how thick the carpet in my rental house be right now? It's a lovely house, I love it here, but I am not a fan of carpet, and it is, it's some thick stuff. Like, you sink into it. Of course she's gonna want to go in Nancy's room, because she's like, it's a girl's room with girls' things that she's never had. what would her life be like if it had been normal, you know? I suppose every little part of like a normal girl's life is incredible to her right now. It's okay to be jealous of that, Eleven. That doesn't make you a bad person. Please tell me she's not going to go and sit with him and his douchey friends.
Probably couldn't stand listening to all that moaning. Oh, oh, Steve. Oh, Steve. Oh, Steve. Oh, Steve.
What I don't like about him is that he doesn't tell his friends to stop. And if you're going to enable them, you're just as bad. Do you get me? Like, I don't like that. Tell your friends to stop being assholes. Otherwise, that means you clearly don't think they are assholes. So you think behaving like that is fine? Like, well, I don't want to be around you then. Went into this fully expecting to love him, and all I've done is rip the shit out of him.
Do you think she acquired them, like Green Lantern?
She's not a superhero. She's a weirdo.
You're such a hater.
I hate to break it to you, Toothless, but he's not in danger. He's dead. That's what my dad says.
Punch him. Come on, Dustin, punch him.
Watch where you're going, frog face.
Oh, one good fucking straight to the nose. Lucas is annoying me a little bit as well. He's such a hater. Like, I get being nervous about her, but that whole, so what, she's a weirdo. Like, you guys are weirdos. You're the outcasts. Come on now. Speaking of outcasts. Jonathan, that's uncomfortable. I'm really not getting the motivations here, but like, I know you wouldn't be trying to be creepy, but you definitely are. She's put them everywhere.
I brought you a casserole.
First person to do something nice for her, so thank God for you. Hopefully she won't judge her too much, because like, if someone's kid was missing, I would fully expect them to be completely unhinged.
You could have at least called, said, Marissa, hey, it's not gonna work out. Sorry I wasted your time, I'm a dick.
I like Marissa. I was gonna say, she didn't want you to ask her out again. She wanted you to apologize for wasting her time. She'd be more inclined to help you if you weren't banging everyone. Shady boy. It's crazy to think there was a time even cops, if they wanted to look something up, had to go to the library. Like, they didn't have their own database of stuff. Like, madness. I see why he's looking into this, though, because, like, that's all going the right way.
It's silly, I know.
No.
Whatever it takes, girl. How are neither of them noticing this kid walking off, too? Who, by the way, is, I know everyone's sick of hearing me say this, but it's the absolute friggin' cutest. She's so precious. So of course she's gonna go look at that. She's like, whoa, never seen this happen before. Don't let it get the kid though. Not the little kid. Not the kid. No. Don't hurt the kid, no.
Thank you for the casserole, but I need you to leave.
3-year-old's like, I want to go home anyway. This is scary.
Sorry to bother you.
Yeah, because she's missing you, ignorant, crappy friend. That's the best I had right now. Sorry, I was concentrating.
Nicole here was telling us about your work.
It is creepy. And it totally is creepy, Jonathan.
No. No, this is called stalking.
Yeah, that really doesn't look good.
And that's the thing about perverts. You just have to take away his toy.
No, don't hurt him. Don't wreck the camera. Come on, dude. Steve, don't be a bully. Don't do it. Don't do it. I mean, I get it. I totally get it, because that was a really creepy, pervy thing to do, but also, like, there's a line, and that was, like, borderline bullying. And look, you can tell she's conflicted as well. I would be. I'd be like, I don't know what to feel now, because I feel sorry for you. But I also am like...
Hey, Nance!
What the fuck? Don't hey Nance me, I'm not a pet. And I get it, thank you for standing up for me, but also... there's a fine line, and I guess it's different because we saw the moment from his point of view, so we know he didn't mean it in a creepy way. We still don't know what his intentions were or why the fuck he did it, but we saw that he wasn't there like, ugh, like leering in the trees. So I don't know, I feel weird about that whole thing. It's a kitty. Don't hurt the cat. Don't hurt the cat. Don't do it. I was about to say the cat clearly doesn't like you, but don't do it. Oh, they're not going to make her hurt the cat, please. Tell me they're not going to make her hurt the cat. Don't do it. Don't hurt the cat. Rebel, 11. Rebel. There you go. Good girl. And that's why they shut her in the room. Superpowers. She's like me. She's like, I hurt people. I hurt people all day. Don't ask me to hurt an animal. He's gonna be like, yay, that's exactly what we wanted. Because if they don't need her to hurt animals, they want her to be a weapon. I'm not gonna send her after cats, aren't they? So the fact that she can hurt people, we're like, hell yeah. We thought we were gonna have to graduate you to that, but if you're willing to hurt people, wicked. Oh, and now he's gonna treat her like a kid, look, so that she gets that affection she wants. That's called grooming. I'm going to comfort you and be nice to you now, because when you'll want to do this again, which is what we want, and withdraw affection and make you isolated when you don't do what we want. This makes me mad. This really makes you realise how tiny she is. I thought that was about to be an end of an episode. I was like, no, I'm not ready.
Hop on. We only have a few hours.
This is cute. Aww. She's had enough of your douchebag friends.
What do you expect, dating Miss Perfect?
Of course you're jealous. Not that I like her, but like, it's not because she's Miss Perfect, it's because you're an asshole and you don't realise.
I just fell at recess. Friends, tell the truth.
She's already savaging you, dude.
I understand.
She understands the whole being bullied thing better than you'll ever know, dude. They are so cute. He does look at her like he loves her, but I don't care. Lucas can shut up. It's adorable. That was Barb's car. I was so confused. I thought it was Jonathan's for some reason. I was like, what are you doing? Look, it's because you know in your gut you fucked up. What do you think? She's just going to be like chilling in the pool on a Lilo like, oh, hey, Nance. Just decided to sleep here. What's that? Oh, the lights are coming on again. Jonathan, when he gets home, is just gonna be like, Mum, what the fuck?
Will, are you here?
Okay. But that's gotta mean you think he's dead. We can only answer yes or no. What's he gonna do? Oh, she is on one. This is where I've seen this. This is so smart. Fair play to her, like mum of the fucking year. Are you finally gonna talk to your mum?
It's Barb.
Maybe Will was in the wrong place at the wrong time and he saw something that he shouldn't have.
It's a reach.
It's a start.
It's possible. It's not him saying he got kidnapped, it's just him saying they could have got rid of him. That's entirely possible.
I told you she didn't know what the hell she was talking about.
Shut up, Lucas.
Guy!
See, and if she hadn't led you there, you wouldn't know this was going on. So shut up, Lucas. He actually annoys me so much.
It's
gonna be right here.
Right here. I don't know what that means.
Get out! He said get out! Run! Move, Mum! Ew! The fuck's wrong with his face? What's wrong with my face right now? But ew! Ooh. Keep forgetting this is scary and then like being like... Oh, this is that lake they were looking at the beginning of the episode, right? The fuck have they found?
Oh God, please tell me it's not the kid.
Oh, please tell me it's not, because they're right there. She's getting remarkably close to police officers for someone who doesn't want to be found. What? No way he's dead.
Mike? Mike?
Don't hit her.
You said he was alive. Why did you lie to us?
No, she didn't. She said hiding. All she said was hiding. She didn't say he was alive at any point. Yeah, sorry, Jonathan. I've got to tell you, a monster came out of the wall. And I bet he's not going to be able to do it when Jonathan's there. She's like, God, I am busy on mum duties today. Oh no, because it'll make me cry. I have such a soft spot for Finn, I can't deal with it. Oh, look, I proper teared me up. I can't deal with Finn crying at all. Oh God, and they're going to come and say they found his body. No. Every time it ends, I don't want it to end. Like, what a bad place to end an episode. Like, not writing wise, that's reasonably a reasonable place to end it, but like, shit, dude. I don't even know how to sum that one up. That was a lot. That sucks. I don't know what else to say. That sucks, dude, and I'm not happy about it. But we're clearly definitely going to be watching more Stranger Things. If you enjoyed the episode, leave a like and a comment. I'm so deflated because I'm like, that was so sad. Subscribe if you'd like to see the rest of Stranger Things. If you're enjoying the series so far, please do leave me a comment. It really helps to let me know that I'm doing the right things. And I guess I will see you on the next episode. Bye, guys.